Hello everyone, welcome back to the third part of budgeting, in which we are going to study about the preparation of budget and the types of budget. This forms a part of the BSc HNHA 5th semester. So in today's session we are going to study about the preparation of budget and two types of budgets, which are the sales budget and the operating budgets. Moving to the preparation of the budget, now as you can see in the image, it forms the most important key factor. The preparation is the key factor. If we are not able to prepare the right budget, our revenues won't go in the right direction. So the whole hotel operations is divided into costs as well as the profit centers, the expenses that we incur and the revenue that we earn. So this fixes responsibility on the various individuals and the staff members who work in coordination with each other at the end to achieve the right income and also to minimize expenses. So each departmental head is involved in the budgeting of his or her own area. This becomes responsibility of that particular head of the department, and he plays an important role in the overall planning of the business. So control is exercised at each source, and it involves the delegation of responsibilities and duties to the various people in his or her department to eventually earn the right kind of business for success. So the starting point for the process of budgeting is determination of the profit target, what our goal of profit is. So budgetary control is the best way through which the profit targets can be achieved. Moving further to the first type of budget, which is a sales budget, it is also known as the revenue budget. And this is the most critical budget in the hotels. So the volume of sales has a very, very important impact on the semi-variable costs as well as the variable costs, and also how much cash inflows into our business and how much cash outflows out of our business. So there is no point of preparing any budget until and unless the sales budgets have been prepared, what our sales would be for the future time. So before the preparation of the budget, all the key factors which limitize the sales of the hotel needs to be examined. In the next slide, we are going to study about what are the factors which limit the volume of sales. So the number of rooms available that we have, if we do not have more than 100 rooms or an XYZ amount of rooms, we will not be able to do more business from the other amount of rooms that we expect we should have had. So we have 100 rooms, we can only do revenue from those 100 rooms. Seating capacity, if our restaurant has 25 covers, we will only be able to take sales from those 25 covers and not from a 50 imaginary figure. Labor shortage, if our labor is not in the right amount for the work that we have in a particular department and the other people will not be able to perform to the best of their capacity, which will eventually lead to less number of clients coming to your hotel to eat the food or take a room in your hotel, and this will eventually reduce the volume of business. If the management quality is not fine, if the management is not able to cope up and take care of the staff and invest a certain kind of a capital, if I read the sixth point, they are not able to put in a lot of capital and investment into the business and into the right direction, this will limitize the volume of sale. Also, one of the reasons can be there can be certain unwanted guest demands which the hotel is not able to fulfill, which will eventually lead to decrease in the guests coming into our hotel, and eventually it will limitize the volume of sale in the hotels. Moving to our next budget, which is the operating budget. Now these budgets are concerned with the income and expenditure of the business. These budgets are prepared for various revenue producing departments, the departments that produce the revenue, and it shows the budgeted departmental profits in each case. Now these budgets are concerned with basically room operations and F&B operations. So for the revenue producing departments, the targets and the goals that are set are in terms of the sales volumes, hotel room occupancies, average room rate of the day, etc. But if we talk about the non-revenue producing departments, the targets are cost ceilings, right? In terms of the percentage in relation to the departmental expenditure. I would like to tell you what cost ceilings are. Cost ceilings is basically, it's a government price control which limitizes to not exceed a certain price of the product. So if I read it on the right, the cost ceilings is a government non-group imposed price control on how high a price is charged for a product, commodity or service. So beyond that, we will not be able to charge to the guest. All the operating budgets are consolidated into the budgeted profit and loss account statement, and it indicates the total of what the departmental profits have been for the minor other revenue producing departments, also known as ORPs. Budgeted undistributed expenses, those can be like repairs, sales promotions, powers, administrative charges, publicity charges, etc. So the difference that we will calculate with what we have achieved and what we have targeted will be known as the budgeted net profit. Moving to the next slide, in the next session, we are going to read about two other types of budgets, which are going to be the financial budget and the flexible or fixed budget. I hope you enjoyed my session. Thank you and see you soon.